Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, the first Polar Starlink launch and the first launch in quite a while from Vandenberg is coming up very soon. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 2.1 launch is scheduled for Tuesday 14th at 3:55am UTC or 11:55pm EDT on Monday. SpaceX posted a tweet confirming the launch date of this Polar Starlink launch. Musk responded with, "These are version 1.5 Starlinks with laser inter-satellite links which are needed for high latitudes and mid-ocean coverage." He was then asked, "Is Starlink going to be deployed between Earth and Mars to improve communication for Starship?" Elon Musk responded and said yes. Michael Sheetz posted a tweet about the Starlink Gen 2 protest. He said Viasat joins Amazon in asking the FCC to dismiss SpaceX's Starlink Gen 2 amendment. Kuiper is hardly alone in observing that SpaceX's amendment is defective at the most basic level. There was an article posted related to Starlink. It says KDDI, Japan's second largest mobile provider, has emerged as one of SpaceX's partners in rolling out high-speed wireless coverage via satellites. SpaceX posted a few tweets related to the Inspiration 4 mission coming up very soon. They said, "Our Inspiration 4 crew has completed astronaut training at SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California, and is en route to Kennedy Space Center in Florida for final preparations and launch." Then there was another tweet saying, "Our crew is continuing final preparations for launch and teams are targeting no earlier than 8pm Eastern Time on September 15th for liftoff of Inspiration 4. SpaceX and Inspiration 4 will narrow down the launch window to 5 hours approximately 3 days before liftoff." SpaceX also posted a tweet with a picture of their Crew Dragon and Falcon 9 integrated in the hangar at LC-39A. They responded to that tweet by saying that this spacecraft previously supported the Crew 1 mission. Chris Sembroski, one of the Inspiration 4 crew members, posted some shots of the crew checking out and touching their ride to orbit. He said, "Resilience is ready to roll, she is on the Falcon 9 and it is a beautiful sight." There was another tweet posted by the SpaceX team. It says, "NASA has selected Falcon Heavy to launch GOESU in 2024. This next generation satellite operated by NOAA will support weather forecasting, severe storm tracking and meteorology research." Michael Sheetz posted an interesting tweet saying, "ESA Director General announces the creation of a commercialization department to incubate space startups." He emphasizes support given to SpaceX, saying over half the company's $28 billion in revenue to date came from public funding. Somebody responded and said, "Government support does not equate to success. Look at government funding of other launch providers and you see a far lower return. SpaceX has actually saved the government billions in launch cost." Then Musk responded with, "Exactly. Getting paid by the government to launch payloads at much lower prices than competitors is not government support." Talking about launch contracts awarded to SpaceX, this Space News article was recently posted. It says, "Yarsat has selected SpaceX to launch its next generation Faraya mobile connectivity satellite in 2023, the company's announced September 8th. Moving on to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital tank farm. Work also continues on the chopstick catching arms at the launch site. These claws for the launch tower have also been spotted at the launch site. The orbital launch mount is also progressing with testing coming up soon. The new wider high bay foundation work continues. Crews continue to work on this new structure which is believed to be a quick disconnect arm extension. Here's a view of the ground support equipment tank GSE-8 in the mid bay. Here's the latest with the heat shield tile replacement on Starship 20. This vacuum Raptor engine was moved to the launch site for Ship 20. As we saw last episode, they lifted Super Heavy Booster 4 back onto the orbital launch mount. There was a Teslarati article posted in a tweet about it of the Booster 4 prototype being put back on the orbital mount. Musk responded with some information by saying, "Booster static fire and orbital launch mount hopefully next week." The first Super Heavy Booster 5 section is in the high bay with this common dome stack. The Booster 5 forward dome was placed on the sleeving mount. This forward dome has also been sleeved with the barrel section. The final thing to check out for this video is the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Booster 5 and Ship 20 are starting to come together, as well as the tank farm being almost complete. To finish this video, I have to thank Stephen Marr once again for being out in Boca Chica filming the majority of the amazing content. Plus, Nick Ansuini has also been out there again filming the Boca Chica content, so thanks to him too. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.